This tutorial is a method of converting MTS files to MP4. First of all, we go to the video help site, videohelp.com, and type in FFMBC into the search box. Then download FFMBC, which is a customized version of FFmpeg. Okay. And when it's downloaded, extract the file. Then open up the folder and copy the bin folder and put it somewhere on your desktop. Then rename the bin file FFMBC 0.5. This folder contains the essential files that we need. You can see there it's got the ffmbc.exe file. Now just copying an MTS file into the folder and renaming it so that it's short and simple to use in the command string which we're going to use. Now right click and create a text document and rename it AVCHD to MP4. Now I have a ready-made command line string which I'm going to copy into that text file. And there you can see this string. We've got the input MTS, then the video codec, the audio codec, strict experimental, and the bit rate, which is 512. Now rename the MTS, rename input and MTS to whatever you want, whatever the name of your file is, and also the output. And rename the text extension to bat and double click on it. And the command prompt appears and begins to process the MTS file, converting it to an MP4 container which Lightworks can import without any problem. Just takes a few seconds. And there you see the MP4 file is in the folder. And if you look down at the bottom, you can see the file size is about right, 308 megabytes. Okay, I'm just double clicking on it now to see if it plays, and it seems to be okay. The screen capture software makes the picture look worse than it actually is. Well, that's okay. Now open Lightworks. And when Lightworks launches, we're presented with the project browser. Scroll up to the top and select your frame rate. In my case, it's 25 frames a second. and give the project a name. Then click on the Create button at the bottom left. Then we're presented with the project card. Click on the Video tab and on the Format drop-down menu and select your setting. In my case, it's 1080, 25 frames per second. Now click on the Import button on the toolbar and navigate to where your MP4 file is. There it is. And you can see that Create Link has been selected, which is the quickest way of importing. And it's found, it's extracting the six channels of the 5.1 surround sound. And there is the tile. And if we open up the timeline, we can see that there are six audio tracks intact. So it looks like it's been a success. And if we extend the timeline so that we can see the waveform, you can see that the audio appears to be okay. That's all there is to it, really. That's the end of the tutorial.